Okay, here we go. A little dry run first, a little dry run. Stacey, just heard some good news. Jack might still be alive. It's not very tactful. Not very good. Okay, another tact. Stacey, Clay and Deborah have some information indicating that you're dead, that your husband, Jack, whom we all thought was dead, might still be alive. It's pretty wacky, right? Wrong. Okay, that's not it. How about this?
Cooper, what are you doing?
Oh, hi, Stacey. Just,
person-to-person communication. How novel. And here I thought you came to my humble home just to talk to yourself.
When you're down and trouble and you need a helping hand and nothing, oh, nothing's going right.
That ought to do a farmhand prize. You really gonna eat all that?
Fries and garlic bread are on the way.
Well, look, maybe you could just cancel that.
You don't look like a big eater. In fact, you... Have I seen you somewhere before?
No, I don't think we've ever met.
Television, that's it. I've seen you on TV.
Oh, no, I don't think so. Maybe you read the papers, maybe you saw me. I do some print work. Maybe that's it.
That's it, television. You were on Oprah. You got one of those, what do they call it? Eating disorder.
You're kidding.
Nope. Somewhere out there, my own flesh and blood is walking around.
I'm an uncle? Why didn't you ever tell me this?
I didn't know for sure until now. I didn't want to know.
And do we have to do this? I want to get to the hospital. Dr. Hannah, he said he might know about the blood test tonight.
Hey, after dinner, man, you need to eat.
Nah, I need to get going on this transplant thing.
Frankie, you don't even know if you're going to be the donor.
No, I do know, okay? I'm going to be a donor. And my bone marrow will save my mom.
Michael, I want this will to be absolutely clear. I don't want Frankie to be unprotected.
With it, Angie. I want you to be comfortable with every comma and colon.
Thanks, Michael.
I'll call you later.
Okay. Dinah Lee, hi.
Hi.
Come on in.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt.
Oh, you didn't. We were through.
I didn't come back.
You heard what we were talking about, didn't you?
You're straightening out your will. Anybody with a child should do that.
Right. I mean, it's not something that I obsess on, but it's just one of those things that you have to nail down.
Especially being a single parent. Here, these are for you.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
Well, I'm using this enforced vacation to catch up on my paperwork.
Oh, I know what you mean. I keep saying that I'm going to do all these things, and then I don't know what happens. I never get around to it.
Well, check yourself into a hospital. You'll be amazed at what you can accomplish.
I think I'll try to find something else. Yeah. So how are you feeling? You look much better.
Oh, well, that's good to hear. It must be the transfusion.
But do you feel better?
I won't be running any marathons, but I feel stronger, and I'm going home.
You are?
Yes, that's what they tell me.
But don't they have to monitor this aplastic anemia?
Well, they can do that with blood counts. I just have to keep visiting the hematologist.
What about the drugs they were trying?
Oh, Dinah Lee, that was a little too hard on me. We're waiting for a bone marrow donor match. And if I get a transplant, well, I could lick this thing.
So the sooner the better, right?
Well, that's what I say. I'm real anxious to get back to work.
Mm. Actually, I'd like to take a week. Yeah, a month off.
Well, so how's Penn's doing?
It's a job.
Oh, that exciting, huh?
Well, kids seem to like it.
What kind of kids?
Your average, normal kids. Frankie comes a lot.
Oh, just so he stays out of trouble.
He does stay out of trouble.
No, mother worries.
Hey, Frankie's a good kid.
Not always. he got mixed up with some bad kids in San Francisco. I want to make sure that that doesn't happen again.
Well, Frankie's gonna be just fine. And you're gonna be right there with him.
Of course I will.
Yeah.
Of course.
Tough luck.
Yeah, what's the difference, B?
How's the reading going? What reading? You know, your summer reading list, Cry the Beloved Country, right?
Yeah, it's okay.
Page 60. He's up on your right hand there. You know, you want to have a smooth, easy shot. Don't stab. So, job at the agency, how's that going?
It's okay.
Gwen's a good boss?
Yeah.
You learned the advertising game, huh?
Well, like the art of moving boxes.
You gotta start somewhere. Speaking of which, hey. You wanna have a solid stance, you know. Move your feet out like this. You know, hit right up over the bar.
Hold on, chill, man. I don't need your advice, okay?
I'm just trying to help out.
I can make the shot on my own, and I don't need your help.
Hey, how about we stop playing this little game, all right? I know what's going on.
Maybe you should feel me.
All right. Mom thinks I need the father type of my life, so this is your typical male bonding scene. Burger and fries, pool, insights on life. You know what I say?
You don't need a father type. You had a father.
Bingo. Now here's a news flash. I still have a mother.
Frankie, look, I don't want to tell you how to live your life. And I've never really told anybody how to do that. I don't have any particularly send lady insights.
Well, great, then we can quit with this power routine thing.
Look, I don't know if we should do that. I think the two of us need to be friends now. We were both going through something neither one of us knows how to go through.
Wait. Let me get this straight. Now, you don't know something.
Come on, Frankie, cut me some slack, please. I don't want to be a father or a role model or whatever you want to call it. But I didn't intend to fall in love with your mother, but I did, and there's just nothing I can do about it now.
You got it bad, huh?
And now she's sick. This wonderful love thing that sneaked up on me, it's got a big, dark shadow hanging over it.
Tell me about it.
I don't know how to handle it, man. I mean, I don't know what I should say to her son, what I should say. Frankie, look, maybe you don't need me now. Maybe right now I just need you. Okay?
Start by telling me how to line up this shot.
Well,
here
hey.
We go.
You and Jack were pretty happy, huh?
Yeah, we had our ups and downs, you know, every couple.
If you don't mind asking, how did you guys meet?
That good old Corinth High, where else?
High school sweethearts.
No, not exactly. I had a tremendous crush on him in high school.
What was it like marrying into the Alden clan?
That wasn't easy.
Do you have any problems with Clay?
That was a bumpy ride. I mean, he was always polite, but you could tell he resented Jack.
Why?
Well, because he thought Jack got all the breaks, that Cabot favored him over Curtis.
Oh, so Jack was the fair-haired boy.
Mm. Clay always thought so.
What did you think about Clay?
Pardon me?
Well, Jack didn't like Clay very much, so you must not have liked him much either.
True.
And yet you married him.
That was temporary insanity. I was going through a very rough time.
I'm sorry for bringing this up.
Yeah, but you did. I mean, isn't that why you came over here? To talk about Jack's death?
Not exactly, Stace.
Well, then, what are you getting at, Cooper?
Not Jack's death. More like Jack's disappearance.
Excuse me, are you saying that Jack never died? Cooper, you can stop playing whatever little game you're playing. I mean, what's your angle here?
I don't have an angle. I'm sorry for upsetting you.
Well,
that was stupid.
Yes, it was. So why did you bring it up like that?
I'm doing research.
On what? On being insensitive?
No, on family history. I'm trying to, you know, think of an idea for a short story for English next semester.
Oh, well, don't write about my end of the Alden life, okay? It's very boring.
Oh, come on, you're not boring.
Don't you think if there was something very interesting to tell that I, as a writer, would have written it by now?
But it'd be about more than just you. It'd be about the whole Alden family.
Cooper, take my advice. Forget about the Aldens, okay? Just have fun this summer. Create your own history.
Sounds good.
It sounds healthy. Not a day went by where I didn't have to remind Jack of that when he got caught up with Alden Enterprises.
Kind of sucks people in, doesn't it?
It sucks them in. It drains their blood, it embalms them, and they don't even know it's happening. You know, Jack used to tell me that he was slaving away for us. But that wasn't true. He was doing it all for Cabot.
You think so?
Yes, Cabot still has a hold on that entire family. You Alden kids, you all feel as though you have something to prove to that man.
Really think that that's true?
Yes, look how many lives have been ruined by it.
Well, not me.
Jack was in the process of changing his course, too.
I'm sorry.
No.
I shouldn't have brought any of this up. And you're right. It was completely insensitive of me. This gotta still hurt.
No, the bad hurt is gone. It's just sort of a sweet ache now.
Still miss him.
Oh, yeah. Every day of my life. Pain's gone. Fear's gone. Not the memories. I still think about him lying next to me. I still think about that old fisherman sweater that I tried to get him to throw out.
Did he ever throw it out?
Mm-mm. No, he was wearing it on the cruise. I remember so much about that cruise. The way he told me that he loved me. The way he would look at me. I remember the last time he looked at me before he went out on deck.
Stace, I'm sorry. I didn't want to make you remember all this.
No, it's okay. I like remembering. It's very comforting. I was loved, Cooper. I was really, truly loved. And when Jack looked at me, especially that last time, it was like... I don't know.
What?
It's hard to explain. It was like souls touching. Well, you'll see. You'll see.
When?
When you find that person that makes you forget to breathe. When time, the world, everything just sort of stops.
I thought I was in love once. At least I thought that's what it was. I think I thought.
No, you don't think. You know. That's when you know.
Yeah.
Yeah. You go through that kind of love just once, and you'll have enough to write about for the rest of your life.
Dream. No, I don't do much else afternoons these days. Watch the soaps, watch the talk shows. They're crazy.
The soaps?
No, the talk shows. They have all these extraordinary stories, all these extraordinary people. I mean, if I'd seen those shows years ago, I tell you, I've learned a great deal about women.
Really?
Oh, yes. Press-on nails. The G-spot. Faking to please your husband. And the fixation of women on weight. I mean, what lengths women will go to keep thin. Thin. purge.
I do not have an eating disorder, okay?
Well, there must be some problem. You've got enough food here to feed China.
Actually, there is a problem.
You want to talk about it? Come on, you can tell Buddy.
Well, why not, Buddy? Everybody in town probably knows about it anyway. I was dumped by the man that I'm in love with.
The cat.
Yes, that's exactly what Clay Alden is. You know, people warned me, they told me this was gonna happen, but I was too dumb to listen.
Well, you have to be very protective when you mess with an Alden man.
That is so true. You know, you do kind of look familiar to me, too.
You know, Oprah says that food is a substitute for love.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't know about that.
Well, it's not much of a substitute. Much better to do it on the phone.
What?
Yes, go phone someone who cares about you.
Huh?
Don't be baffled, girl. This is the 30s. Get out of bed. Look alive.
Yeah, it worked, Joe.
All right.
Let's go see your mom.
All right. All right.
Bob, keep.
Hey, keep the change.
Thank you.
So Egypt's the one who told you all this?
Yeah, she was always looking for a way to stick it to me. Had to know everything about everybody I'd ever been with. She's the one who tracked down Pam.
Now, Pam's the mother.
Yeah, I didn't know she was pregnant when we broke up. And Egypt held that over my head, let me tell you. Anyway, I hadn't a clue where Pam had gone to.
But you tried to find her?
Oh, yeah. I heard a private eye, went the whole nine yards.
Did you get any leads?
Just some pretty depressing details the private eye got.
Oh, yeah?
Pam was living with her parents back then. She hid the pregnancy as long as she could. Came the day, they kicked her out.
Where'd she go?
Nobody knows. Nobody knows what happened to the kid, either. She should be a teenager by now.
This is something, no, Buck.
Isn't it? I'll tell you something else. I aim to find Pam and that kid.
And then?
Dinah Lee, I'd appreciate it when Charles and Frankie show up that you didn't mention this will and my lawyer being here.
No, I understand.
Thanks.
Actually, I've been thinking about putting my life into some kind of order.
Well, I thought things were fine with you.
Well, maybe they will be. But right now, I just think that Trucker and I need some time apart.
Oh.
I have to figure out if we have a chance at anything.
I know you think he hasn't let Trisha go, but hasn't he shown you in any way at all that you two could make it?
Angie, I really have to talk to you.
Where's the joke? 1994? Yeah, I suppose Roosevelt's pulled us all out of the Depression and the whole world's hunky-dory, huh?
When you find that person who makes you forget to breathe, time, the world, everything just sort of stops.
Oh, what's wrong? Oh, you're mad at me because I dragged you away from Cass, I know. I'm sorry.
What?
I have really needed somebody to talk to. And you know, you're the best friend that I've got right now.
Steph, look, about our
I know. Things have been really screwy. I've been totally crazy, but that's what happens when you fall in love with the wrong man.
Steph.
I was definitely the wrong man. But you'll be happy to know I've decided to get out of bed.
What?
I'm moving on. I just hope that I can find somebody as wonderful to me as Tess is to you. Anyway, thank you for coming today. Oh, there's this really neat old guy. You have to meet him. He's...
Who?
Oh, his name's Buddy. He's a hoot. You're gonna love him. Now, where did he go?
Yeah. Me and commitment have never really gotten along too well.
That's changing.
Maybe. Only thing is, being a dad before I'm a husband, it's never really the game plan.
And after that, we play some pool at the rodeo.
Oh, a real man thing, huh?
Yeah, Frankie got a pretty smooth shot. Someday he might even beat me.
What are you talking about? I'm gonna beat you next game. Hey, Donnelly.
Hey, guys, hey. How you doing? Hey.
How'd it go?
Fine. I hope I'm a match.
All right.
Me too.
Great.
She got tested.
Oh, that's great, Donnelly. Yeah. Thanks a lot.
Sure.
Thank you.
I should be going, but, thank you for arranging that other thing for me. And remember, no one is to know.
You got my promise.
Okay.
You take care of yourself, okay?
Yeah, bye. Bye, guys.
Bye. Take care of yourself.
Good night. Yeah. And thanks a lot for getting tested.
Yeah. Excuse me.
Charles, Frankie, I'm glad you're here. I have the results of your blood tests.